So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 36. Here's Brissett. And he's got this to Jefferson. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7. Given 30 yards there.
All right, Charles, let me put you in the head of one of those defenders out there. You have a big play like that go against you so early. What does that shake your confidence?
It shouldn't, but it often does, because your thought process all during the week is how you're going to get after that offense and make your plays. And when they make one against you, makes you a little bit hesitant.
Time to regroup.
Brissett now. That one thrown away from the pocket. The officials kind of looking at each other, but they'll say there was a receiver in the area, so no penalty, just an incomplete pass.
No sense risking anything there on first down. Even though he's still in the pocket, he had a receiver out to his side, so just put that in a spot where the only people who could make a play on it are the trainers and the coaches. Well done.
On second and goal, Brissett. And it's caught in the end zone for the Viking touchdown by Justin Jefferson. A 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Vikings will strike first here in this wild card matchup. Extra point splits the uprights. And that makes the score 7-0. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Down, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
But they're certainly not neglecting their run duties as well, as they ate up the blockers in front and allowed the secondary to get home.
To start out here, second and 11.
He'll look to throw. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And now the Vikings are going to stop it here on defense with a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. An extra defender in the secondary for the Vikings here on third down. A play action fake. They'll look to throw. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked off by Lewis Seen.
He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
Well, we got to give him one, don't we? I mean, with the year he's having, a lot easier for he and his teammates to accept that throw, because for the most part, what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. To throw is Brissett. Touchdown, Vikings! Justin Jefferson
his second touchdown of this opening quarter. And the Vikings are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point right down the middle. And that'll make the score 14-0. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Charles, it's kind of gut check time. Look, I know it's early, first quarter, just their second drive of the game, but they've already thrown the interception, given up the score. You're down double digits. They got to figure out something and pretty quickly here.
No doubt about it. And when we look at that sideline, I'm sure you're observing the same thing I am. I don't like the body language at all. They look like they're in a state of stunned disbelief. So to me, we always talk about someone stepping up and making a big play. I think it would behoove them if multiple guys step up and make big plays right now. They need something positive to happen. They need for it to happen now.
They'll look to throw now on first down. That one almost intercepted, but it's incomplete. Not a good throw there, and it'll be second down.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted.
Picked off by Eli Apple, and the Vikings are going to take over at their own 41.
I believe this is what you would call growing pains here, partner, because this defense obviously took the challenge facing the rookie, and they wanted to help indoctrinate him to the NFL. So now the big question is, can he answer that challenge and rebound with plenty of time remaining in this game?
They start the drive with Cook. And some room to run now. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first. Again, it's Cook. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line.
44 yards rushing for him already. A terrific first quarter here to begin the playoffs.
Solid running there. And, CD, we hear so much about what it takes to win in the playoffs. Most people like to include having a strong running game in their assessment. And with this man in the backfield, this group has a strong running game without a doubt.
Oh, I absolutely agree with you there because in terms of yardage, he's a top-5 running back in the league. And in terms of impact on a game, not many better than him. And when they're flowing and he's carrying the ball consistently, they're tough to beat.
His second catch of this wild card game, and it goes for a first down. Left side, Cook. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. The last run got a couple. Here's 2nd and 8. Up the middle, it's Cook. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4.
In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down.
3rd down, Dalvin Cook. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the 6. That'll make it 4th down after a loss of 1. The score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. going to get the kick off in time. And the first play will be a field goal try. This is an easy one, 23-yarder. And his kick here is good. And that will extend their lead even further. Well, they already had the early lead, and they get the interception, Charles, and now they add three more with the field goal.
Yeah, they're in control of how this game is playing out so far. You mentioned the early lead. Now they're expanding on it, getting plays on both sides of the ball. A winning recipe if they can keep this up.
And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he'll get this up just shy of the 30. The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. They'll drop the throw. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Lewis Seen. And the Vikings are going to take possession of the football. So his struggle is just continuing here in the first half, throwing the football, Charles. Now three interceptions.
And they don't feel like they're just great plays by the defense. There's a sense that maybe he's a little careless with the football now. So some of the great coaches in the past, you know what they've always said? I can't teach you, obviously, because you're not listening. So maybe.
And he's going to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line. Brian Burns flying in there and dropping it for the sack. Now, following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Brissett. Throw left side on target to Thielen. It's a pickup of 12 and also the third down.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on first down. They didn't get a lot of money. But now they look at third down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
Brissett sets to throw it. And he's got it. And he is out of bounds here. The gain of five that time gives him the conversion. It makes it first and goal.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence. And that one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
They'll go with a keeper. And he'll get in. He's over for the touchdown. The sneak successful from a yard out. And the Vikings continue to pull the playoff surprise as they lead big here on the road. Point after, right down the middle. And the route is on here in this first half. Minnesota's kick team ready and the Vikings boom it away. This one fielded at the five.
The Panthers take over first down 10 at their own 24-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They've got to be a little shell-shocked. Down double digits at home in the playoffs. Still in the first half, they've got to turn things around quickly. Flush to his right, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Za'Darius Smith, give him the credit for the sack and a loss of 14 yards. So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often, second and 24. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. They'll get nine there as that sets him up better for third down. He'll drop to throw. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by Lewis Seen. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Well, Well, CD, we have seen it many times throughout the course of the season, this defense coming up large and snagging a big takeaway. But here they get not just the takeaway, 6 points as well.
And you just knew that for this team to advance, it had to get a big performance from this unit. And to this point, they've delivered.
Extra point splits the uprights, and a rout is on here in this first half. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This one fielded at the five. And he's going to get this across the 20 as he's out of bounds at the 23. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we're having a tough patch, this too shall pass, this too shall pass. And finally kept having a rough patch. He said, but you got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. They'll need five on this play to move the sticks. They'll look to throw here. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Lewis Seen. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. I cannot imagine a more perfect half of football for one side, CD, and a more disastrous half of football for another side. But if you focus on the positive half, with this pick six, you look at where that lead is at, and to think that we are only in the second quarter, my goodness.
I love the expression, my goodness indeed. Pretty obvious, it's a free ball out there. Everybody gets a chance to make a play. And if you're on the field, you've got a great chance of being the next guy that your teammates are celebrating.
Taken in at the three. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers.
He's got a man complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
I hate to say it, Charles, but the way that he has played in this first half, you just kind of hold your breath every time he drops back to pass.
Yeah, you might be holding your breath, but those guys on the defensive side of the ball, they've got big smiles on their faces. He's handing out picks like the people just leave the candy out at Halloween and you take what you want. They're having a blast out there playing against him today.
And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. Able to get away. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
A big loss. Brings up fourth down.
They're going to try and throw. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, Carolina. A big play there as the first half is winding down. And the Panthers are on the board here in the final seconds of the first half. Extra point right down the middle. And they get a bit of a respite here from what's been an otherwise dreadful first half of football. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And with a huge lead already, they may be thinking, hey, our job's complete for these first two quarters. Let's get this to the locker room. On play action, Brissett. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Throw it, Brissett. Field, so he'll throw it away.
Well, they approached this drive with a lot of confidence after the last one ended up as a touchdown, but incompletions on their first two throws has them huddling up and trying to figure out a big play here on third down to get their momentum going again.
On third down, Brissett. He sets to fire deep. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. So we come upon halftime here in this NFC wild card matchup as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. One of these two teams about to play their final half of the season as we're back at it in this NFC wildcard bout. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And Charles, that had to be an interesting locker room at halftime. This is a team that's had so much success this year. Haven't really had to deal with a lot of adversity at halftime, to be honest. But now here they are with their playoff lives on the line.
And I think when you're alluding to that interesting locker room, you're just wondering, how are they handling that bit of adversity that they're seeing right now? Because I think this is a team that has to look to lean on the veterans at this point. We know we're better than this. We've proved it all season. Let them disseminate that confidence through the locker room. But this opening drive, it'll be an important one for them to give them a little jolt of confidence moving forward.
Here's a second and 7. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. His second catch of this wild card game, and it goes for a first down.
Well, Charles, what a rookie season he had catching the football over 1,000 yards on the year, and he comes through there with a nice grab.
And we've seen wide receivers in recent years come in and have big years right away. And you think about Justin Jefferson in 2020, 1,400 yards and huge impact on his team and on the league. This guy, he's following his footsteps as an impact guy here in year one. certainly played up to their top 10 defensive ranking this week. They've stifled this opposing offense throughout this game. This contest is now lopsided because of their efforts, and there's still a quarter to go.
Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. On play action, they'll throw. He'll buy some time right. And now here's another interception. Picked off by Lewis Seen. And the Vikings are going to have it here at their own 32-yard line.
Well, I certainly think that we're seeing a big reason why this team has struggled to put points on the board so far, because too many of their drives have ended in turnovers already, and we still have almost a full half of football yet to play.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And the first half definitely went their way, and this would seem to be a great opportunity to kind of put this game a little closer out of reach with a score here.
Yeah, and it's a wonderful opportunity for them, because if they can add seven more to their lead before the other guys even see the football, that could be the decisive blow in this game. I think that's how they're eyeing it. That's how they're approaching it.
From the 39, Reset swinging this out wide here for Cook. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. Play fake, Reset. And that's complete to K.J. Osborne. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. The partner is still in the third quarter, but they've got this one well in hand and still airing it out with gusto and picking up some nice gains.
And even in lopsided games like this, you don't really see starters get lifted or the foot come off the gas before the fourth quarter. No one wants to leave any doubt when they're playing well. They just want to continue the process.
Off the play fake, here's Brissett. Buying time to his left. And he'll just get rid of it.
Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here on this drive, but a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on first down. Now they have to gear up, try and get two more stops and escape this drive.
Third quarter, wild card round. Thanks for being along for the playoff ride with us. Here's second and 10. They'll throw again. Brissett forced out to his left. That's to Cook out of the backfield. And he's going to get this down near the 25.
Everyone has their strengths, able to move to the right or their left, being able to throw the football. So that means you've got to work on both, because you never know which way you're going to get flushed by pressure. In this situation, able to escape to his left and makes an accurate throw.
They'll run it. Here's Cook. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Dalvin Cook, 25 yards to the house. And the Vikings extend their lead yet again. Point after, right down the middle. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go.
As this offense takes the field against CD, remember last drive, they were moving the football, but then they threw that costly interception, so we'll see if they can right the ship here on this drive.
And doesn't that just sum up football? We see it all the time, don't we? The defense goes from losing the battle to making a huge play and stealing the momentum. So you know they're riding high right now, and they're ready to challenge this offense and that quarterback one more time.
And we'll see if the offense is up for that challenge here as things start to get more interesting here in this second half. Multiple players getting home there for an 8-yard loss. Going to need a crafty play call here. 14 yards is what they need to try to convert this thing.
Now the throw on third down, knocked away and incomplete. incomplete.
That was well played, but that was also an example of a corner who understands his coverage, realized he had support behind him, and could be a little more aggressive in the shorter zone, and did exactly that, knocking that pass away.
They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And this is caught. He hits Moore. And he is going to have a Panthers first down on a well-designed play there. That gets him 16 to move the chains. Now here's a handoff out of the gun. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. One quarter remains in this NFC wild card matchup. And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And a five-yard gain gets him to the 42.
A nice run right there. And we talk this time of year about certain teams, certain players who don't have a lot of postseason history to speak of. And here's a man right here in his rookie season in the NFL, and he's being asked to carry the load at running back for this offense.
And he has acquitted himself nicely here in his rookie year. And look, I think we both believe that the burden is a little lighter on backs and receivers than is on quarterbacks in the playoffs. To say this is going to be easy. As fast as the NFL game is in the regular season, it's like warp speed when you turn the pressure up in the postseason. So let's see how he handles things early.
And nearly sprung that time as he takes this all the way down to the 37. 42 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries. They held him in check in the first half, but that's his longest carry of the game right there.
So would this be the definition of fresh legs since he didn't get much done in the first half? Now he has a great opportunity. He's taking full advantage of it.
They'll look to throw here on first down. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he's going to get this down near the 25.
So a great throw right there, and what a regular season this rookie had, piloting this offense, guiding them to a division title, and they get the home date here in round one of the playoffs. But Charles, how do you think they'll play it here? Will they run the same kind of wide open offense they've run all season, or do you think that they'll try and take some pressure off of the young fella?
Oh, I think they're going high, wide, and handsome in this one. I think it's all out, just as they've been doing all year long, because I think if you try and pull it back now a little bit, you're telling that.
He's got a man complete. And he's brought down after a very nice game. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup.
Well, I mean, look, obviously there's no 20 or 30-point play in that playbook, but they can try to end things here on a positive note despite trailing big, and that looks like what they're trying to do here by pushing the ball downfield.
Well, let me go with the heavy cliche then, partner. Just control what you can control right now, and all they can control here is how their final plays develop.
They'll try to run this one in. And he takes it into the end zone for the Panthers touchdown. A great effort there with his second touchdown of the night. And the Panthers get a small measure of revenge as they cut into this fourth quarter deficit. Extra point splits the uprights as they make the score just a slight bit more respectable here in the final quarter of play. The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Well, we've reached the stage where it's a mere formality at this point. They've got the comfortable lead. We know what the outcome is going to be. I guess the only question is, do they want to put more points on the board before the final gun?
Well, I certainly hope not. And I'm being selfish here because you and I have flights to catch. Let's go ahead and finish this one off, guys. You've taken care of business. Let's close it out. And you and I, let's get to the airport.
All right.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. A 10th carry in the game for Cook. Room here to run. And he is finally going to be brought down, but not before he gets it to the Panthers' 16-yard line. A big play there out of Cook. Give him 53 yards on the ground. Big run here in the fourth as they continue to wear down this defense.
And that's when the offensive line coach clicks onto the headset and says, "Head coach, offensive coordinator, let my guys fire out and hit people. We're wearing them down. Let's finish them off with the running game."
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. They run it again with Cook. He will push his way down to about the 14. 2 yards that time, a stark contrast from the big chunk on the previous play.
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them moving forward.
Second down, Cook. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and they're left with a third and eight. The Panthers turn to their nickel set here as they get ready for third down. Third down, here's a run by Cook. And they're going to lose some on this play. Being knocked back to the 18. A rough go there on third down, a loss of four. They said beginning of the season they wanted to get past the wild card round. Well, they just got past the wild card round.
How about that, being able to put the big check marks up in the locker room, right? Yeah, you know, get to the wild card game, check, got that done. Win a wild card game, big check. Now you've got to go ahead and set your sights higher. There is a bigger prize out there, and they still have an opportunity.